count percentage of them are quite activist supporters of my son, and they pushed me towards a sort of social action that would prove that there are very little limits that cannot be achieved by patients with type 1 diabetes. So we decided to go to mountains, to high mountains. Our goal was to cross the barrier of 5,000 meters. And after 3 years of preparation, last July, we climbed Dalmat mountain in Iran, which is almost 6,000 meters of height. It was an achievement because of at least three reasons. First, our group consisted of 18 type 1 diabetes patients, and only few of them were actually sportsmen. The majority of them were just average members of our society with regards to physical activity. The second important issue was that due to the political situation in Turkey, our flight was significantly delayed by almost 2 days, and we have very little time for acclimatization, so we reached the peak within 3 days only, which may be the world record for diabetics for sure. And the third issue was that all the devices that were used off-label. That includes insulin pumps, blood glucose meters, and systems of continuous glucose monitoring. So let me just concentrate on this performance of the medical devices. As far as the pumps are concerned, we did not experience any problems related either to infusion sets or alarms, etc., etc. So they were doing good. That includes the 640G, which six of our patients were on 640G pump, and with the predicted low glucose suspend option set for 70 milligrams per deciliter, it was stopped on average 3.3 times a day. Actually, we did not experience even a single episode of severe hypoglycemia. As far as blood glucose is concerned, it was definitely elevated, but I think it was still reasonable. So to our surprise, we had more problems with dealing with hyper rather than hypoglycemia. Here we present results for three systems, regular hand blood glucose meters for flash and continuous glucose monitoring systems. All three groups of devices were showing sort of similar trends. However, with altitudes, the gaps between hand blood glucose meters and other systems tended to be bigger, and this was especially clear for flash blood glucose monitoring systems. So, with altitude, its performance seems to be worse. However, we had no reference method to compare its devices in the correct way. And also we had problems with getting the raw data from all our participants. We didn't have a reference method because it was not possible to freeze blood samples and take them out of Iran. So our conclusion is that as far as insulin pumps are concerned, they were doing really well at high altitude. And as far as the systems of continuous or flash blood glucose monitoring, this requires further studies. Thank you very much.